Lighting can be very difficult. You can make it as complicated as you want with just one light, or you can fill it up with some nice practicals. You can also make the entire scene look a lot brighter. Let's take it back. That's better. The thing that you can do with lighting is infinite. And when does a frame look correctly? Well, in this video, we're going to take a look at how I create my YouTube videos, but also what the thought process is behind lighting interviews. Since my YouTube videos are quite the same, I don't need to prep as much. But for an actual interview, I plan things a lot more. Once we know the location we're shooting in, I like to create a simple lighting diagram using Photoshop and a tool called Film Set Objects to create very simple yet detailed lighting plans. Once this is done, I present this to other creatives. I also make mood boards. I use Shot Deck for this. It's a tool created by Lauren Schur, the DOP of Joker. It's basically a huge database of film stills with loads of metadata. This way you can easily navigate through different scenes to find exactly what you're looking for. Let's break this lighting setup down first. For an interview, you typically want a key light. That one. A key light is the main light source exposing the subject or talent. And in some cases, this is enough. But if you want to create a visually more interesting looking image, you want to consider using different lights, like that one. All right, so after you have found a spot where you want your talent to be, you know where to place your key light. I like to have my key light at around a 45 degree angle away from me or away from the talent to create a nice contrast on the face. Let's see what a different key light angle does to the contrast ratio on the face, the light fall off, and also what it does to the mood of the film.
Frank is holding the key light straight in front of me, and he is slowly moving to the side, and you can see that the contrast is increasing. Right now we're parallel to my face and you can see that there's no light left on the left side of my face. Now we're in a 45 degree angle behind me and you can see that our key light became an edge light.
Okay, so now that we've positioned our key light properly, we can play around with some practicals. A practical is basically a light source that is present in the frame, like that IKEA lamp for example. After having set up the practical, the thing that I like to do is to see what kind of light this practical creates and if I can use it to create a more realistic setting. Therefore, I used a Godox LC500R, which is a light stick that ranges from 2500 Kelvin all the way up to 8000 Kelvin, but also lets you toggle through a 360 degrees of view. Now, I mounted it on a C-stand and I extended the light that comes from the practical to fall on my shoulder and my face. This is called a rim light. We use this technique to separate the talent from the background, but also to create a more three-dimensional looking image and to give it a little bit more depth. Framing is also a very important step. I personally like to use as much depth as I can find, even if that means I need to cramp myself into the corner of a room to get it. But sometimes you find yourself in situations where there is just not a lot of space to work with. Then you might want to think outside of the box. This here is a perfect example. It's a flat background, it has no depth whatsoever. You know, usually it would look pretty horrible. So, what I used here is symmetrical lines. I made sure that everything from the middle until the sides roughly looked the same. Then I also used a couple lighting techniques to make this scene just look a little bit better. Let me turn off everything and then, you know, build it up from scratch. There we go. It looks kind of horrible. So what I did was I used a Godox SL60W with a mirror and some gaffer tape to create this look. Then I used my key light to light my face. I used my Godox LC500R to, you know, use it as a rim light to create a little bit of depth. And then I used my practical to fill this space up with some warm lighting as well. This already looks a lot more appealing to the eye. So with a little bit of creativity, you can definitely manage to create something like this.
All right, let's take a quick look at what we built here. So we got our key light a little bit over 60 degrees away from us. I pointed it away from the wall because I didn't want the spill of the light onto the wall. Then we got our mirror. It is a basic reflection setup, but I made a grid from gaffer tape onto the mirror that created the pattern you see behind me. Pretty cool. Then we got our LC500R on the left side of me that just gives me a little bit of extra from that, you know, practical that's there. It just lights up the shoulder, otherwise that shoulder would be pretty dark and I didn't really like that. I blocked off all the windows in the room with black cloth to, you know, have full control over the setting. So that's it.
As mentioned in the beginning of this video, lighting can be very complicated. You can sometimes use 20 lights, but you can perhaps get the same result with 3. It really is difficult, and therefore you need a lot of experience. One thing that I like to do whenever I walk onto a set is to see where the natural light is coming from. And then I try to either boost it, enhance it, or block it off and recreate it if we need to shoot on that set for a longer period of time. By using that tip, you can always light a scene. It's just your creativity to create extra things like this thing I did with the mirror and some gaffer tape. Lighting is probably the most exciting thing about cinematography, and it definitely changed my way of how I view the world. If I walk outside and there's a nice path of light or a shape that is created by light, I get intrigued by it, I would say. So, guys, let me know what you think. Is this something you want to do? Is this something you want to get into? Are you as intrigued by lighting as I am? Let me know. And I hope this video was helpful. And if you liked it, you know, let me know in the comments below. I'll see you guys next week. Alrighty.